Hey guys, it's Hafei. I'm back again, and today I am going to do a nail art tutorial. This is going to be for the Geeks and Beauties collab. Someday I'll find it the perfect collection, which is a Muppet-themed collaboration. We have a choice of doing panning or a makeup look or a nail art, and each month there are two Muppets. January's Muppets are Gonzo and Animal. I'm going to do a Gonzo nail art today, and I'm also going to do an Animal makeup look at some point before the end of the month. So let's just get into this. For my bluish Gonzo colour, I've used this one here from Rimmel Lasting Finish Pro. It is called Hard Steel, because the actual original Gonzo Muppet is actually a grey blue. Even though he's often depicted as bright blue, it's more of a grey blue. And on the middle finger right there, we have two coats of My Twin Mimi from OPI. I'm sort of going to do a like the when Gonzo's a superhero type thing, although it's not exactly what's on his thing that I can remember, but it is on what's on costumes of the great Gonzo. So that's what I'm going to do. I'm going to be using acrylic paints. I have them on my thing. They're spritzed with water. If you can hear a noise in the background other than my dog, it's probably the fan. If you didn't know, as I'm filming this, Australia is in the middle of a heat wave, and it has been like high 30s, early 40s, that's in Celsius. You know, it's around 95 to 100 Fahrenheit for the last 4 days, I think it is. It's a little bit unpleasant, and I've avoided filming because it's been unpleasant, but I need to get these done. And I kept thinking about them last night when I was supposed to be sleeping, so I'm going to get on with it. Okay, so we're going to start on the yellow finger right there, and I'm going to use some bright red, and I'm going to draw a triangle. My paint's a little bit too watery. It'll be fine. We can always go back. Alrighty, so we're just gonna let that go dry. It's not exactly straight, but that'll be fine. And I'm going to mix up sort of, Gonzo is kind of, he has this mouth and nose area that is, apart from being hooked, is kind of this weird, almost pinky brown with, I don't know, like blue bits to it. I think it's supposed to be like flesh toned. So we're just gonna fiddle around and see what we come up with. I haven't practiced this, so I'm winging it, and I work upside down, so sometimes it can be a bit hard. Trying to plan things out properly. Okay, so we're gonna do. Start off with this kind of thing, which is sort of his upside down mouth shape. Thank you. was out of frame for it, but I just kind of like mapped out the face kind of area. It's not perfect by any stretch of the imagination. These things are generally not. But I'm just gonna let that dry for a bit and then I will come back to it. So I'm gonna go over here to where my red heart is. I'm just gonna take some yellow. It's actually not quite the right yellow. So I'm just gonna add a tiny bit of red into a bit of it. And we are going to do a letter G. Turn my thumb finger over this way so I can see what I'm doing better. Basic shape on there. So now that I've got the basic shape where I can actually use that as a guideline, doing letters upside down is really, really difficult. So we're going to let that dry. We'll come back to that in a little bit. We're going to go back over here. It's kind of a speckly, almost blue, light blue type of colour. I'm just going to, the nose part. And then sort of around the outside edge of the mouthy area, kind of where I've put the black. I don't know actually how much we're going to see of this by the time I'm finished, because I'm actually doing something else to it afterwards. You can still see a little bit of the underneath colour on there as well. So I'm just going to go back into this eyelid area. And he actually does have yellow eyelids. Real careful, his yellow eyelids have a very thin, pale blue edge to And now for something. Well, actually, we're going to go over to this one here, the VG one. We're going to take some darker blue, like a mid-toned blue. And we're going to outline it. And that is that one done. So, I'm just going to give that a moment to dry. I'm going to do something a bit different on this nail. And I have to do it like really super carefully because otherwise I'll mess it up. But I have this stuff which is like... fluff, I guess you could call it. And it can be used to make things look fluffy, so it's like a flocking type of powder. Now it is white, but that is going to be okay because we'll work around that. So what I'm going to do is, because I want to make the painted bit shiny anyway and make it all kind of meld together, I'll take my sash feet and I'm going to layer that over the top of it. That makes everything kind of meld together. Do the same with this one. Not doing anything to these other two fingers. We're just gonna leave them. I should probably put sash feet on them though, because I hadn't done that. Distracted. My bottle's getting a little thick. Oh, and I dinged my arm. I didn't even realise. Oh well. Too late now. Alright, I'm just going to give that a bit to dry and then I'll be back. So, what we're going to do now is I've got a different brush. I've got some of the base colour on a little thing. I'm going to go around what I've painted. Just put a very thin coat of nail polish on. And then take a pair of tweezers and drop some of this on there. This is not how the final product will look. Don't stress. Sneaky. just going to tap it down with my finger. Make sure that everywhere got covered. And let's do this just right there. Right, and then I'm going to let the polish dry. I'm just going to take a fan brush and brush off any excess around the nail. It's not 100%, there's some areas that are probably a bit light on, but you'll still get the effect. So then what I do is get some more of the nail polish because I'm not making old man gonzo. And I very carefully paint over the top of it, or nail polish over the top of it. There you go. Gives you a slightly fuzzy look. If you're wondering whether the fuzzy stuff comes off, not once you put something over the top of it. So that is it for this video. Make sure you check out all the other girls who are involved. Their links will be down below. If you want to subscribe, click the button down below. Give me a thumbs up if you like nail art tutorials. And leave me a comment down below. I try to respond to all comments, and I'll see you in my next video. See ya!